You're filming right now?
Yeah.
How's it going?
Hi.
What's your YouTube channel?
It's Cutie Crafts.
Cutie Crafts. Awesome. Well, hope you subscribe if you haven't already subscribed. Do it right now.
Hey guys, you're watching Cutie Crafts, and it's finally December, which means the holidays are fast approaching. So I just recently finished all my classes and labs, that's why I have time to make this video. And in the last lab where I was making some aspirin, I got this idea of making some Christmas tree ornaments that have the theme of science and chemistry. I've seen this old Facebook post where somebody actually took a retort stand and put some clamps with flasks attached to it, and these flasks had all sorts of different colors of substances to make a chemistry. I thought this was a really cool idea and I really liked it, so I wanted to decorate my empty tree here to make it look cool and unique. So I've got a few designs for some chemistry / science related Perler bead sprites. They're really simple, so you shouldn't have a hard time following along, and if you do, just pause the video and copy down the designs, and let's get started. Starting with the round bottom flask, I'm just making a black outline here, and you can use any color to fill this in. I'm going to be using white on the top and then any other color, so I've chose blue. And don't forget to choose some clear beads to make it look glass-like. To fuse the beads together, I have my iron set at 3, and then I'm just going to place my parchment paper on top and iron it with circular motion and a little bit of pressure. I don't want to press too hard on it, otherwise it'll be too flat. And then once I'm finished fusing one side, you can see it all on the paper, I'm going to flip it over to the other side and do the exact same thing. And after your project has cooled down, you can just peel it off of the paper, and there you go, you're pretty much done. It's just as easy as that, and the other projects will be very similar. The next one I'm doing is a test tube, and again, I'm just making the black outline, and you can fill it in with some clear beads or any other colored beads. Next up is a beaker. I modeled this after a 50 milliliter beaker that I worked a lot with in my lab. I'm using dark blue beads to make the measurement lines and white beads to make that little label thing that you usually see on a bunch of lab equipment. The last piece of lab equipment that I'm making here is an Erlenmeyer flask. It has more of a cone-shaped bottom as opposed to the round one that you saw in the beginning. And after adding the clear beads as well as white measuring lines, I'm going to put in little bubbles to show that a reaction is occurring or has occurred, and then I'm filling it with any color. Now, if you're interested in genetics or maybe the chemical makeup of DNA, then this project is kind of fun. You get to make your own genetic code, and first off, you have to start off with your double helix structure or the twisted ladder structure. I'm just using white as the outline. For the four bases that are in DNA, I chose blue to represent A, green to represent T, yellow to represent C, and red to represent G. And all I'm doing is pairing them together. G always goes with C and A always goes with T. So you can see that the blue bead always goes with green beads and the red can only ever go with yellow. Of course, you don't have to choose the same colors as I do. You can choose any four colors to represent the base pairs. And if you don't want to follow the base pairing rule, well, you'll just be making a mutated strand of DNA. You can do whatever you like. It's your genetic code. Have fun with it and make it unique. Oh, and because this is a chemistree, you can never forget the periodic table, which I am making here. I just found an image online, so that's where I got the idea from. You can choose whatever colors you want to represent the groups, and that'll be your own little periodic table for your tree. To top the Christmas tree off, I've created a Bohr Rutherford model of an atom. It kind of looks like a star, and I just chose to use translucent yellow beads to make it kind of glowing. And I think there's a bead that's misplaced at the top. If you can see that, just make sure that goes in the right spot. And that's how it should look in the end. I've made a whole bunch more of these ornaments in different colors. Let's see what I have. 5 round bottom flasks, 4 Erlenmeyer flasks, 3 test tubes, 2 beakers, and 2 DNA double helixes, a periodic table of elements, and an atom for the top of the Christmas tree. And finally, I'm just using some craft string to tie up all of my ornaments so that they can go onto the tree. You can use twine or fishing string, whatever works for you. And I'm just tying them in a way so that these 2D sprites will face forward since they are flat and I don't want them to, you know, go on the side and not be seen properly. So I'm just tying them that way. And once you're done with all of them, it's time to decorate the tree. Alright guys, so I am back with all of the ornaments all stringed up. And let's start decorating the tree. So that is my chemistree, and of course I cannot forget the lights. Yay! So tell me guys what you think about my chemistree. Do you like it, hate it, think it's interesting, very different? I'd love to know your thoughts on it. And okay, so the real reason why I wanted to make this video was because a few weeks ago I had the amazing opportunity to meet the creators of AsapSCIENCE, Greg and Mitch.
How's it going?
Hi!
It was really cool to listen to their talk about how they started YouTube after their studies in biology. And it's just really cool to hear the story of people who have been successful academically in school as well as creatively on YouTube. They were so sweet to agree to be in my video for like 5 seconds. That was really fun, and I was probably the only one pointing a camera at myself. So I hope you guys enjoyed this kind of video. And by the way, this is Mountain Dew, so don't ever drink any weird substances out of a beaker if you're in a lab. But you will be seeing this cup again in another video that isn't a Perler bead project, so hope you're okay with that. And thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time with another cutie craft.
Hey cutie, I've tried to make your horse from one of your videos. It was a tutorial on how to make simple animals. Love you cutie crafts, bye!
Love you too. See you next time.